here we are at Obsidian Dome. You can see that the wall of dark rubble here is all obsidian. So basically this is the edge of a big obsidian flow or rhyolite flow. And so obsidian is just a type of rhyolite that has cooled very quickly so that it's quenched to a glass. And so in parts of this flow it's quenched to a glass, in part it hasn't. So this flow is actually pretty big. It covers, I don't know, a few square kilometers at least. And it's sort of flat on top. You can sort of get the sense that it's flat on top from looking at it here. Unfortunately, without a satellite picture, it's hard to really tell. But it's basically too viscous to flow on any thinner sheet. In fact, you know, even at its current viscosity, it has a tendency to break apart in chunks like this near the edge of the flow, such that the edge of the flow is more marked by chunks of obsidian than, you know, what looks like more of a liquid sort of lava. So, you know, to put it differently, it sort of flows like an ah-ah flow, where it breaks apart into chunks and brecciates. If you look up into the cliffs, you can see some more straight layering in it flows from the interior of the flow. You can also see that some parts of it, if you look up close, so you can see it's all obsidian. Some places of it are a little bit rough, or some have vitrified. So, you know, basically, why some places parts vitrify and some don't, it's hard to say. In general, these glassy obsidian flows tend to be the later parts that are volatile poor. Probably the answer is that volatiles like water help catalyze the crystallization of the rhyolite. And so if it's typically one of these eruptions, all the gases bubble off first and you have maybe more of a Plinian style eruption. And then later on, after all the gases are gone, then you might end up with an effusive eruption at the end of the stuff that didn't have enough gases in it to erupt explosively, but in this case also didn't have enough gas to catalyze crystallization of the rhyolite. And I mentioned this in a previous thought, but again, this obsidian dome is one of the 80-1350 eruptions. So, you know, just 650 years old, that's not too old. And there's a whole series of them that came in around that time. I think plus or minus a year or two. They've narrowed it down that much based on tree rings, is my understanding. Okay, cool stop. I'll pick up some sample. So here we are up on top of Obsidian Dome. You can see the students down there. Some of them might be waving at you. And so this is to give you a sense of what the top of one of these domes look like. Actually, you can see over there on the next hill is the Glass Creek flow, another one of these 80-1350 flows, and you can see it's kind of got a flattish top, and then it's got this sort of scraggly cliff edge around the edge. So these things flow out in these big, thick flows that are maybe 30 to 100 meters thick. And then up on top, they're just jagged rock. So this is the top now of the Obsidian Dome flow, and you can see it's just a forest of jagged rocks. The highest part of the dome is over there. That's probably where the vent was, where it came up out of. If you actually look on satellite pictures, you can see a bunch of concentric sort of flow lines around that, which are not obvious on the ground, although maybe if you sort of squint, you could maybe imagine seeing lines curving around this way. Might be more obvious from other pictures. But anyway, that's what the top of Obsidian Dome looks like. Just scraggy points of rock. Looks like a good place to film a sci-fi movie.